Hello everyone. So we are currently discussing the formulae for addition, removal and shifting of mass on board a ship and its effect on stability. We have already seen that when a mass is removed from a vessel, we have to use this formula. The shift in center of gravity Gg1 is W into D by W minus W. And we also discussed that when we are adding a mass somewhere on a vessel, we have to use the formula Gg1 is equal to W into D by W plus W. So let us now look how these formulae are applied in case of ships when a mass is added or removed. So you can see here a situation where there is a removal of some weight from a ship, somewhere from a ship. We all know that ships, merchant ships are basically mediums to transport cargo from one port to the other. So loading and discharging is a very important activity on board a ship for transfer of cargo. And during loading and unloading, there are a lot of forces generated, a lot of moments developed, which try to disrupt the stability and equilibrium of the vessel. It is very important that we need to understand the nature of these forces, the types of moments which will be generated. So if we get a understanding of what will be the forces, what will be the moments and what will be its effect on the vessel beforehand, before actually when we load or discharge cargo, then we can plan our loading and discharging accordingly so that safety, stability is not compromised. So just for this reason, this section, this discussion becomes very important for us, for any seafarer who is going out to the sea. Now let us discuss this scenario where we have a ship where G is the center of gravity of the ship and we are removing a mass from the ship. So let us imagine that a weight W is removed from a height d, the distance between the center of gravity of this weight, the location of this weight and distance towards the center of gravity of the vessel is small letter d. So weight W at a distance d apart is removed from the vessel. So because of this removal of mass, as we have discussed earlier, there will be a shift in center of gravity from G to G1. And this G1 will be located, the new position of center of gravity, G1 will be located away from the position of W, because as we have seen, this is a scenario of removal of mass. When we remove mass, center of gravity will shift directly away, geometrically away from the position from where the mass has been removed. So G will shift to a new position G1, and the distance Gg1, that is what we need to know, how much center of gravity has shifted. Gg1 can be calculated by the formula which we have derived earlier, W into D by W minus W. So this is the formula used for removal of some mass from ship. And suppose if you remove a mass W which is at a distance D below the center of gravity. Previously we had discussed the scenario where the mass was removed from above the center of gravity. Now we have moved a mass W which is at a distance D below the center of gravity G of the vessel. So as a result, like the previous case, there will be a shift of D, but the difference is the G will be shifting top, towards the top, that is away from the place where mass is removed. So now we know, like when we were discussing about buoyancy and weight, we were simply worried that according to Archimedes' principle, whether weight will be equal to buoyancy or not, whether the ship will float or not. But now we are going one step ahead in this discussion. We are also trying to understand from which part of the ship, when you remove a mass, what effect it will have on ship. So now by this discussion, you are able to understand that if you remove a mass, the weight of the vessel changes. When you add a mass, the weight of the vessel changes, and definitely because the draft also changes, the buoyancy will also change. So that will definitely have an effect on the weight buoyancy balance. But more importantly, the location, the place from where this mass is removed or added, that is also very important consideration in stability of ships. So this is where we need to consider about where, in which tank, in which hold are we going to load the cargo or discharge the cargo, or in which tank are we going to load the ballast water. So these are the considerations which come to us in a port during loading and unloading activities, which will have an effect on stability of vessel. So in this case, as you have clearly understood, a weight W is removed from a position below the center of gravity. The shift of center of gravity can GG1 can be calculated by the same formula, W into D by W minus W. So is this discussion same with the discussion in the last slide? The formula looks to be same, but definitely the difference is the GG1, the shifting of G to G1 has gone in a different way. Previously the G1 was below G, in this case G1 is above G. So this is something fundamentally we have to keep in our mind. So here you can see a weight W is removed from a position at a distance D, which is radially away from center of gravity. Now here you have center of gravity G, and you are moving a mass W, which is at a distance D, radially from G. So here we need to apply the rules of mechanics. So we know that G moves in a direction opposite to W along a line joining the center of gravity and W. This is how we can find out the new position of center of gravity. G1 will be in a line connecting G and W, and G1 will be away from W. So that is the fundamental thing we need to keep in mind. So the transverse component of D is dx, as you can clearly see in this figure. So the vertical component is dy. So we will have gg1x, that is a horizontal shift in a transverse shift in center of gravity, and we'll also have vertical component gg1y, a vertical shift in center of gravity component. And we can apply the formula. The formula basically is the same, only the weight is applied is different. These three formulae will help us to identify how the final position of G1 will be, how the effect of shifting of mass on a ship or removal of mass on a ship has had an effect on the vessel. So the basic conclusion from this discussion today is the center of gravity of a body or a ship will move directly away from the center of gravity of the removed weight. So that is the fact which we have to understand, and the opposite is also true. If you are adding a weight, adding a mass, the center of gravity will move directly towards the center of gravity of the removed object. So this is the fundamental idea we need to keep in mind, and using this we will be working out some numericals which will help you to understand this section better. So I hope you have got some idea on how the formula is to be applied in these type of questions. If you have any doubts or not able to follow what is being discussed, please feel free to email me at pramod.imu@gmail.com. That is my email ID. Thank you for listening. Take care.